There were worries when Labor won government that it would wind back the intervention in the Northern Territory's Aboriginal communities, which made sure parents spent some of their welfare payments on their children. Well, Indigenous Affairs Minister Jenny Macklin this week said the intervention would be extended. Parents who don't send their kids to school would have their welfare docked. Northern Territory's Indigenous Advisory Council Chairwoman Bess Price joins me. Bess, this is great news, right?
It is great news, what Jenny Macklin's trying to do, and it'll be great to see it, you know, being taken a bit further, extended, so you know, it can help our people here on the ground.
Extended in what way, Bess?
Extended in that the funding doesn't stop. That's what we're worried about. As long as we have funding to help our people with the education, with the health, with the housing, that would be great.
Now, we've seen some Indigenous leaders actually complain about this, saying that the problem is that you'd be cutting welfare to the parents, you're hurting the kids.
This has been talked of for years, so many years. My sister was a teacher, she's passed on now. She was a teacher, she started teaching in the 80s. And even then, people were saying then that we need to penalise the parents because they're not helping to send their kids to school.
My dad was a teacher in the Northern Territory, Bess, and I get the impression that education standards, particularly for Aboriginal kids over the last generation, have dropped.
That's right. And what I've always said is that, look, treat our children the same as you treat anybody else in Australia and give them quality education that's needed and to teach them properly.
And I just wonder, Bess, whether this is something that shouldn't be extended to people on welfare throughout the country, that if you're not sending your kids to school, you get your welfare docked, whether you're Aboriginal or non-Aboriginal.
That's right. It should be across the board. When the intervention was rolled out, people complained that it was just targeted on Aboriginal people. So Jenny Macklin went out and consulted with people and then decided that it should be other recipients as well of welfare payments. And you know, she's been able to do that here in the Territory, and why not do it with parenting payments?
Well, I think you're right. Now, listen, when you put up your head as an Aboriginal leader to advocate things like this, boy, do you sometimes get it kicked. And I noticed that people like the education activist Chris Sarah was saying, for example, that you're just a pet Aborigine excusing the intervention like this. How do you respond to that kind of, well, I think it's a racist slur?
Well, Chris Sarah, I really supported what he was about. And I was so grateful that we did have people like Chris Sarah out there who was fighting for the rights of our people. But to say that about people like myself is not downright. It's worse than what you'd been through, I guess, for myself, because coming from a fellow Aboriginal person and academic, it's made me feel as if we don't have brains in our head to decide for ourselves what's best for our people here on the ground.
Yeah, no, and, look, you're quite right, Bess. I thought it was right out of order. Thank you so much for joining us, and good luck with your work.
Thank you.